Chairman Young, what could it be?
Well, what I look at is the fact that we aren't bringing tremendous new investment, these new major facilities like Boeing, like Hyundai. They're just not even giving Ohio a look because of our failure to get right to work. And I think our economy would greatly benefit with a multiplier effect. As we know, if we bring in a factory that has 200 people, that certainly employs them, but also they go to stores and shops and help finance the school district, those types of things. So there's a tremendous multiplier effect of having these large plants located here. And but right now, we're just not even on the list of states they look at. So that's why I'm kind of, that's what I'm looking at. As far as your question is, how would it interact with the current locations that are here that have union, like the UAW plants? I think the workers will see benefits because I think the unions will have to compete for their business, for their membership. And that's why you mentioned the family member I have where his attitude is that the union isn't really working hard for him. I think they're kind of stuck with him. Yes, they support having a union, but he feels that if the union would have to be more competitive and compete for those membership dues, they'd do a better job. And I think that's what would happen. And in future testimony, we'll show that that is, in fact, what has happened in the state of Indiana, where the unions have spent more, have been more competitive, and really worked hard for their membership dues.
Thank you. Very good.
Representative Beck.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Is this on? I don't think maybe it's on, but I think we should check that. And so you're saying that it's correct, but you're saying that we need government intrusion in our country for the citizens of this country who go to war, who built the planes, made the steel, built the ships, that the government is going to take that right away from them. Do you think the government has a right to take this away from the Americans and from the state? And we have effects that we in Ohio will make less. Education we will not have the money for K through 12. Higher education goes nothing but up. We know our benefits are going to go down. You're saying right to work is the right thing for Ohio because we're going to lose jobs. We're going to have a poor economy.
Is that a question?
Yes.
Chairman, not Representative Fedor. Well, I too have had experience in my family. In 1969, when I was 12 years old, my father and grandfather's printing company had a major strike in Cincinnati. My father lost his company. We were forced to move out of town to find a job he could. Cincinnati, which was at that time the second largest printing center in the country, behind Chicago, was decimated. By the 80s, we weren't even in the top 10 because factories moved out. Most notably down south, where there were right-to-work states. And so I know what, have that experience, too, in my family. I think that when I see all these states, 25 of them, who have adopted right-to-work, and how their economies have grown, I never even thought about the Sun Belt back in the 1960s. I mean, that was where a bunch of, who lived down there. But now that's where everybody's going. That's where the jobs are going. Look at the explosive growth of Atlanta, for example. Phenomenal opportunities down there for all races, creeds, and colors. That's where the population's gone. So I think that right to work has shown over decades, where people are voting with their feet, that they're going to those states because of that opportunity. And that's why I want to make Ohio a right-to-work state. So that number one, we stop losing all these people and all these jobs, and that we start attracting jobs and opportunities. Ohio has tremendous advantages, but right now we're not even getting a second look, regardless of our location and the energy we have and the clean water resources. I think right-to-work is a great component that will attract jobs and opportunities to our state, turn around the population decline, and make it a great place for my six children and someday maybe grandchildren to stay, work, and prosper.